now apparently just known as Wil Wheaton. I'm going to tell you some stories today about gaming, and then I'm going to take some questions from you if you have them, and then I'm going to leave. So, thanks a lot for coming. Before I get started, this thing says, I think it says no filming, but so this is my time with you today. You're welcome to record as much as you like, and it is released under a Creative Commons Attribution Non-Commercial Share Alike license. You know, I've been coming to PAX since 2007, and it's one of those things that feels at once like a very, very long time ago, and like it just happened yesterday. And this year is the first time since I started coming to PAX that I actually like have a career now, and I'm working a lot, and I didn't even realize until like 5 days ago, oh my god, PAX is in 5 days. And I've spent the last 5 days bouncing up and down every time I have a seat somewhere. There's been a lot of like running from place to place, a lot of this while I go to places. And as I walked toward the convention center today, I got that feeling of like going home and going back to summer camp. And I got really excited. And it's almost enough to cut through the headache I have because I stayed up till 2:30 this morning playing Dragon Age RPG with my friends. You know, I've been playing RPGs since the early 80s, and I started with the D&D Redbox set, and right with the coloring dice and everything. And the way that I approach role playing is I guess it's really, really old school. I just like to tell a great story. I like to work and collaborate with my friends to tell a story that really entertains us. And my friend Will ran the most amazing Dragon Age game last night. We didn't use minis. We didn't really use anything sort of tactical. We all sat down and told a story with characters that we've now leveled up three different times. We started at Gen Con last year, and then we played at PAX last year, and then we played again last night. And it was so much fun that when I woke up this morning and my brain was like, the fuck, dude. Seriously? You stay up until 30, then 2:30 the night before PAX starts? And I was like, well, you know, in case I forget to be an enforcer someday, I should probably be a dreamy. So, some of these stories are about role playing, some of them are about classic video games. They're all about how much I love. So this was recently published on my blog, and it's called Will Buys a New Game. It's super effective. A pair of 20-something bros dressed and posed in a manner that was such a hilarious cliche, if I described them exactly as I saw them, my editor would have said, you have to rewrite that, it's too cliche, stood near the front of the store, communicating in some kind of broglish language that leaned heavy on the word fuck and its many derivatives. I'm rated M. I should have said that when I walked out. Sorry. I guess I'm Old Man Wheaton. Let me just pause for a second and tell you Old Man Wheaton's story. There's these kids who live up the street from me, and they're sweet kids. They're really sweet kids. They're like probably, there's three of them, they're like probably 7, 8, and 10. And they like to ride their dirt bikes, like you do. And they race their dirt bikes up and down my street all day long. And my street's on a little bit of a hill, and my driveway is a hill. And like you do when you're that age, they like to race their bikes as fast as they can down the hill and then sort of let their momentum carry them up my driveway. You know, sort of like pause at that sort of like apex of like, I guess, you know, dirt bike weightlessness, and then speed back down the driveway. And I saw these kids doing this like maybe 2 weeks ago. And they were, the thing is, none of these kids are wearing bicycle helmets. Now, look, I never wore a bicycle helmet until recently, and, you know, I didn't get that much head damage to myself. But I was worried, you know, because people tend to drive too fast on my street. And these kids were racing down out of my driveway, and I kept replaying this image over and over in my head of the kids racing down the driveway and just getting hit by like, you know, like the secular humanist in me was like, I should probably go out there and tell them not to do that. And then like the practical realist in me was like, you're gonna get sued for the rest of your life if they die riding their bikes on your driveway. So I opened up, so my son and I, Ryan and I, were sitting in the house, and I saw this happening through the dining room window, and I said, I gotta go. I'll be right back if this gets to me, to not do this. So I walked out and I said, hey, you guys, really love what you're doing. And it's like, you like really, like with the skidding and like the skidding to the side, like you guys are, you know, like you're doing whatever the bicycle equivalent of cleaning the cube is. Like, you really, you guys are boss. And because I wanted to speak to them in a language that they would kind of understand. So I was like, look, dudes, the thing is, I'm worried that someone's gonna hit you when you race down the driveway like that. So like, I don't want you to like not ride your bikes and everything, but you know, just don't ride them down my driveway like that, all right? And the kid looks up to me, like you know, sort of like the alpha child, looks up to me and he goes, school, bro. Which is good, S apostrophe cool, bro, okay? I understand that. And I said, thanks, sorry. And the kids, you know, go right up the street and they continue their riding up and down the street. But they're just not, they're not coming up the driveway anymore. And I go back inside and my son says to me, well, congratulations, you just told kids to get off your lawn. I tore a bunch of tendons in my ankle.